While Judge Kaczmarek's ruling makes its way through the courts, there's another case out of Washington State that we're tracking that stands in conflict with his decision. Led by Washington State's Attorney General Bob Ferguson, attorneys general in 17 states and the District of Columbia filed a lawsuit challenging any sort of ban on mail order abortion. A federal judge in the state of Washington affirmed their lawsuit, so now these states are acting as if the rules don't apply to them and plan to keep mailing out abortion pills for the foreseeable future. It's also coming to light that leaders in these blue states have been stockpiling abortion pills, likely for quite some time. To unpack this, we're joined now by Heather Hacker. She's a former assistant solicitor general in the Texas Attorney General's office and now a partner at Hacker Stevens LLP. Heather, thanks for joining me. Can you explain the latest on this case out of Washington? What does it mean that this ruling in the case conflicts with rulings out of Texas and the Fifth Circuit to stop abortions by mail?
Yeah, so this lawsuit was filed in February. It seems like it was filed perhaps in direct response to the Alliance for Hippocratic Medicine's lawsuit that was filed late last year in the Northern District of Texas. But as you mentioned, it was filed by several state attorney generals. And essentially they are purporting to challenge the 2023 REMS protocol from the FDA, but it's kind of a weird position that they're in because they're challenging that, yet if that protocol was removed, the rules would actually be more strict, which seems to be contrary to what they're trying to do, which is relax the rules. Hmm. Setting that aside, the court actually, shortly after Judge Kaczmarek issued his preliminary injunction decision in the Alliance for Hippocratic Medicine case, the judge in the Washington case also issued a preliminary ruling staying any action that the FDA would take regarding mifepristone. But the court there declined to make this ruling apply nationwide and only made it apply to the plaintiff states. Hmm. So only the states that participated in the lawsuit basically are getting the relief that they were requesting, which is that the FDA cannot change any requirements with respect to the REMS in application to those states only.
Meaning that abortion pills would still be accessible in those states, essentially. Heather, what's your reaction to the fact that some pro-abortion governors have been stockpiling abortion pills kind of, you know, leading up to these cases? Governor Jay Inslee in Washington says he's stocked up 30,000 doses of abortion drugs. Governor Gavin Newsom in California says he has 2 million abortion pills stashed away.
So it strikes me a little odd that a state would be stockpiling a certain type of drug. And it seems odd to me, I guess, because if the law was that, you know, these lawsuits at the heart of them is whether the FDA rightfully approved use of the drug or whether the recent changes to the protocol complied with the law. And so if the drug becomes unavailable, it would be because there's no approval. And so it seems strange that I don't know what they would be using the stockpile for unless it was to continue distributing it despite the lack of approval, if that is what ends up happening as a result of these court cases.
Seems dangerous for the people that live in those states. Heather, what are pro-life attorneys general doing in response to this? What can they do?
So I think that there are several states that have filed amicus briefs in support of the some of the positions taken by the plaintiffs in the Alliance for Hippocratic Medicine case. I'm not sure that they, you know, I don't know that they necessarily are taking action of their own, but you know, they are. They're participating in the Alliance for Hippocratic Medicine case, at least some of them.
Good to know. Well, Heather Hacker, thank you so much for joining us today and for shedding some light on this. We're really grateful to have you on the show. God bless you.
Thanks for having me.